Yeah, hi. We are starting with a session. Give me just 2 minutes. We're starting with a session. Yeah, hi Ashutosh, hi Devarsh, hi Priyank. So we are just taking a few questions today just to understand how to solve things faster. So the idea as far as I'm having a lot of network connection, I'm still having a network connection, just bear with me for some time. I mean, net is not getting connected. I'll just reconnect in 2 minutes. So just give me 2 minutes, I'm just trying to get live. Hello. Fine now, let's see if it works. But the basic way to go fast, I mean, we are talking about speed. Speed is normally very important in a speed-based test, like the CT, SNAP, NMAT. But speed is also important in the logic based test like CAT. It's not that CAT you can go slow, CAT also you have to go fast. So whichever exam that you take, you need to be fast in the examination, and that is what will help you to be good. Now one way to be fast is try to calculate, be good at calculations. So if you're good at calculations, you can be really fast in the examination. If you can solve it orally, you can do different things, that will definitely help you to become better and faster. So we'll look at few things and few ways of how to be a little fast, taking up simple sums. Okay, try to solve it, put the answers down. If possible, try to solve it orally. If you can do that, nothing like it. Initially, you may find little difficulty, but over a period of time, it will help you. Now this, whatever questions we take, will help you for any exam. If you look at banking exam or any aptitude examination, this should help you off. Right? Hi Jayesh, hi Vivian. So we will take few questions, so try to solve, and then maybe you can look at the, put the solution down. The important thing also in a speed based test is understanding the question. If you don't understand the question, it becomes a little difficult for you to understand and crack as far as the exam is concerned. So let's try to solve. So see if you can. Hi Naveen. Right, so if you get the answer, just put it in the chat box. I'll come to know you got the answers, and then maybe I can explain it to you how to go about solving. But as I said, the key in going fast or being good in anything is trying to solve orally and mentally. If you can do that, it will save you a lot of time and will help you a lot. Okay, so good. So what is asked is total profit. First of all, the question is very important. Whenever you read something, you have to focus on the question. The question is, what is his total profit? That is what is asked mainly. If what is his total profit that is asked, that means per chocolate, I'm not worried about it. Ignore per chocolate basis. You don't have to worry about it. Okay. So, and also a lot of things are given percentage. So whenever things are given in percentage, you should always think, can I start with 100 and then maybe cross multiply? Sometimes it works. So can I start with 100 and then cross multiply? For example, in this case, say if I start with 100 as a cost price, because they've asked profit, profit is on cost price. I'm just solving it orally for you to make for helping you understand. Say I start with cost price is 100. So my mark price will be 140 because 40% above cost price. On 140, I give a 25% discount. So 25% is 1/4, remember that. So 140 pay 1/4 is nothing but 35. Like you can do 1/4, you can do by half and half. 140 half is 70, 70 half is 35. So 35 rupees discount, 140 minus 35 will give you 105. That means my cost price is 100. My selling price is 105. So I'm making 5% profit. 5% profit on 48,000. So 10% of 48,000 is 4,800. 5% will be half of that, which will be 2,400. Yes, good. Look, understand that. I'm again repeating it orally and then I'll write it down also. Since they ask total profit, I don't have to worry about the individual question. So I have to only about talking about. Start with 100. 100, 40% above cost price will give you 140. 140 give about 25% discount is 1/4 discount. 1/4 discount is 35 discount. It will give you 105 as the selling price. So your cost price is 100, selling price is 105. So automatically profit is 5%. 5% of 48,000, you can say 10% is 4,800. So 5% is 2,400. Easily get the answer. So I assume cost price is 100, mark price will become 140, selling price will become 35, that is 25% discount. This will give you 105. So my cost price 100, selling price 105, so my profit is 5%. 5% of 4,000, 48,000. So you should know 10% is 4,800. So 5% will be 2,400. Okay, I'll send you number. You can message there. You should be able to get a Telegram, this one. So for Telegram, till then you can solve, others can solve the second question. But for Telegram, you can then use the number 9821314788. Just send a message out there. You should be able to add to a Telegram. Right, let's take the second question again. See if you can solve it. Look, initially anything orally could take time, but over a period of time when you start solving orally, it becomes much faster. As a matter of fact, even the question that come in the CAT exam or any exam, you can solve orally. So try to figure out how to solve orally. That should help you to get things better and faster. Right, solve this sum. Again, I'm telling you, this particular methods and sums will help you in all exams, be it banking exam, be it speed-based exam like NMAT, SNAP, etc. Also CAT, because the techniques are used in every exam. So if you can use, you can try to solve. Think how to solve this orally. I mean, if you can't, you obviously use a pen, but think how to solve orally. That should help you. As I said, it helps over a period of time. The techniques will help you to be fast over a period of time. That is the key with regards to any speed-based test. Four doesn't mean six version, but good. Yes, I'm waiting for more answers. So I'm assuming you are there to try solve it. Understand that these are techniques and tricks you should be good at for solving any aptitude examination. three answers so far. I'm assuming the others also are solving it. Right, so let me just try and solve it. So we want the present age of A and B is 41 years. And we want the difference in age of C and D. Understand that? So A, B, C, D, all is important. So let's try to work on it. So age of A 4 years hence is equal to age of B 1 year ago. Look, we have to start with this 41 for sure, because that's the only age given to us. There's no other age given to you. So we have to start with 41. So sum of present age of A and B is 41. Now, age of A 4 years hence is equal to age of B 1 year ago, which basically means you can make out that B is 5 years older than A. Age of A 4 years hence. 4 years later, what A's age is, B was 1 year ago. Then very clearly B's age is 5 years more than A. If I want to solve A's age, from 41 subtract 5, that is the extra age of B. From 41 subtract 5, which is extra age of B, we left with 36. 36 divided by 2, that will be age of B. Sorry, that will be age of A. Okay, I repeat again. First I will solve A's age. So A's age 4 years hence is equal to age of B 1 year ago. Okay, which means the difference in the age is 5, where B is 5 years older. Remove that extra 5 years. So 41 minus 5 is 36. 36 distributed between A and B equally. So B, A will be 18 years. A and D is 3 to 4. If A is 18, D will be 24. Now I got D's age. Now I want C's age. Now if you look at A is 2 years hence is equal to C 1 year ago. Difference of A and C is 3 years. That means C has to be 21 and D has to be 24. The answer will be 3 difference. Right? So I will just write it down. A plus B is 41 and B is 5 years more than A because of this. 4 years hence is equal to B 1 year ago. So remove this 5 years from here. If you remove this 5 years, 36. 36 distribute equally among A and B. 18 and 18. So A's age is 18, B's age will be 18 plus 5. The extra 5 will go to B. But I don't want B's age, I want A's age. Now A is 18, A and D is 3:4. 3 stands for 18, so 4 will stand for 24. So we will get D as 24. Also, if you look at C's age is 3 years more than A as per the given information. So which will be 18 plus 3, which is 21. So difference in D's and C's age is 3. So yes, 3 years. Good. So if you have been able to solve it orally, nothing like it. That is the key with regards to improvement. This is a little difficult to solve orally, but if you can, nothing like it. As I said, this is a little difficult to solve orally, but if you can solve it orally, nothing like it. I will solve it orally and show it to you. But yes, such bigger sums, it makes sense to write a little bit so that you don't get wrong. But when you're practicing, do it orally. That should help. So when you're practicing, do it orally, it should help. So I will have mocks which is there. Schedule first mock is already released. I will have general sessions on mock analysis which I will put it up. For individual sessions of mocks, I will only do before my students because of time issue. Yeah, Gio, I'll try to make a video on mock analysis. Thank you. Okay, we'll solving the third question, trying to solve the third question. Supposed to take four questions. 12% goes to PPF. Left is 88%. From the 88%, 38, which is 33%, goes to clothes. So difference between clothes and PPF is 33 minus 12, which is 21%. 21% stands for 10,500. So total 100% stands for 50,000. You can make out 21 ka half is 10.5, 100 ka half is 50. Yeah, I know it's buffering. Just write down the answer so you can understand it. 21 ka half is 10.5, so 100 ka half is 50. So total salary is 50, total salary. The remaining amount is 55 because 12 plus 33, 45 is gone. 12 plus 33. 45% is gone, so left is 55%. 55% is 27,500 because 100% is 50,000, so 55% is 27,500. House rent expenses 1,500 less than other expenses. So here this is on house rent and others. So as I said, 1,500 less. So remove 1,500 from 27,500, which is 26,000. And then divide equally among house rent and others. So house rent will be 13,000. Others will be 13,000 plus 1,500. Since I want house rent, it will improve in the future. I will wind up right now. I think it should hopefully work. Sorry for the buffering.